Hey guys, Brad here, and I want to do a review of Victor and Rolf's Spice Balm. And I got the little sample right here, sample card, a 1.5 milliliter sprayer. I've been wearing it most of last week at work. Let me give you my thoughts on this one. This is classified as a woody spicy. The note breakdown: bergamot, grapefruit, pink pepper, and alimi in the top. Middle notes of saffron, paprika, and cinnamon in the middle notes. And in the base, vetiver, leather, and tobacco. At base notes, we have 23 positives, 9 neutrals, and 7 negatives. So a pretty good basic score from the base note community. Okay, I got a little bit on my forum here. This one... get a lot of cinnamon here, just a nice sweet cinnamon and some other spices. A lot of people say it is sort of like a holiday spice, kind of a smell or a blend. I think it's pretty pleasant. I don't have any problem with this one. I think it's a great scent for the fall or the winter. Could be like a cold weather signature scent, that type of thing. I did get one compliment at work while wearing this one. So a pretty solid, pleasant fragrance in my opinion, sort of like the standard mainstream, crowd pleasing type smell. I would say maybe a bit generic, uninspired, done to death already kind of a thing. This one doesn't have like a lot of the interesting notes in it like some of the other ones you may have tried, like Dior Homme Intense had the cocoa and the iris. L'Occitane's Eau de Beau had the cypress note. Bulgari Black had the rubber note. This one just kind of gives you the standard smell, the spice, some sweetness, maybe a little saffron in there just to give it a little bit of a, a floral bite. But nothing too different from what I've smelled before. Kind of reminded me of when I did ST DuPont's Intense. A little bit of D-Squared 2's potion kind of vibe going on here. The thing that's good about this one, though, it did seem to be pretty aromatic, at least for the first hour or two. People should be able to smell this one quite well when you wear this, at least for a couple hours. And then it starts to tone down. But I would say, 3 or 4 hours, you should be able to be smelled. So I give this one pretty good scores for the projection longevity. Some people say it smells like bubble gum. I don't really think it smells like bubble gum myself. I think there's enough, warm, sweet cinnamon here to kind of give it just a spicy fall fragrance smell, not so much bubble gum. I haven't smelled 1 million, but I have heard comparisons to 1 million as well. I think some people say it's most feminine. I don't think it's overly feminine either. Of course, I think a woman could pull it off. And my opinion, it's a solid scent, but a little bit uninspired. It doesn't reinvent the wheel, but it just takes that wheel and just gives a very nice, solid set of tires, so to speak, I guess you could say. So a great gift idea for anybody that doesn't really have a lot of fragrances to fall back on in their collection. If you already have like a top 20 fall, winter, niche / designer set of fragrances, this one might fall a little bit flat, but for most people, I think this one's going to come across as a very nice, pleasant holiday spice type fragrant smell. So nice. I would probably prefer myself something along the lines of like a John Varvatos vintage myself, for the holidays and the fall and the winter. But I'm sure most people will be fine with this one. A nice, attractive bottle, has like a hand grenade shape to it, but I wouldn't say it's necessarily juvenile. I think I would say this is probably more like a 21 and up fragrance, slight mature vibe, but certainly not too mature. Just a nice solid like college and up fragrance. So let me give you some scores here. The smell, I give it 7.5 out of 10. Solid smell, maybe just a little bit done to death kind of a thing there, but not bad. 7.5 out of 10. Uniqueness, that's where it kind of falls flat. 5 out of 10. You know, your standard sweet, spicy, holiday spices kind of a smell. Versatility, 6 out of 10. I would say day wear, evening wear, anytime it's cool outside, fall, winter, this one's pretty solid. Wouldn't really wear it in the hot weather. Maybe like a summer night, you could pull this off as well. But yeah, mostly cooler weather for this one. So so versatility, 6 out of 10. Protection, longevity, I gave it 8 out of 10. Almost too strong in the opening, you know, but you know, a couple sprays and you should be set for several hours. Price point, I believe this one is going for about $75-$80, Sephora or whatnot. So not the greatest value, 5 out of 10, and I don't really see that getting much cheaper anytime soon. So overall, 7 out of 10. You know, doesn't reinvent the wheel, but most people will probably find this one quite pleasant. You know, you take your girlfriend shopping and the sales associate gives you a whiff, and you'll probably be like, wow, that's pretty nice. Maybe I'll take a bottle of that home with me. So, yeah, Spice Bomb by Victor and Rolf. You might want to check it out, especially if you don't already have a large collection of fragrances to fall back on, because this one's solid. Bit uninspired, but you know, most people don't have 100 bottles in their collection, so they're not really going to care anyway. So there you go. Victor and Rolf's Spice Bomb. Thanks for watching. Talk to you guys later.